We brought Bill Engvall in to defend me or not, vis-a-vis the Judy Collins.
I've made the same mistake.
Okay, over that particular song?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you know Anne Murray recorded a version of it too?
Oh, boy.
Yeah, because at our house, I was like your house. Right. It was either that song or every Carpenter song ever written.
Yes, yes, yes. Wow. And did you have, I had older sisters. Did you have older sisters who played all that stuff?
No, all mine were young, but my mother was. Remember the movie Detroit Rock City?
Sure.
That was that scene where the woman sits down with the tumbler full of wine to put on the Carpenters and it's Kiss. Right. That was literally at my house. it's like I'm just going to sip my wine.
Listen to some music. You kids go play.
Listen to Close to You.
All right. Can we compare drinking stories of our parents? We had my dad was kind of a teetotaler, but my mom wouldn't mind a belt or two.
Right.
And we had an FBI agent across the street, Mr. Hogan.
Uh-huh.
And she would go over to Mr. Hogan's house for cocktail hour almost every day.
I remember that my dad would come home from work, and literally his hand would be on the doorknob, and my mother would be standing with the scotch going, hi.
Wow.
And he would take like 2 sips. She goes, let me freshen that for you. Yeah. Like,
no, but that's something. People, but my in-laws used to have cocktail hour.
Uh-huh. He never drank before 5, but at 5.
Look out. It's on.
All right, when you went on this cool safari, was there alcohol on the trip?
There was, but, you know, we went to Africa, and the thing that was funny for me was...
Look at that.
That was at the gorillas. Those kids were amazing. What they do is at the end of the game drive, at the evening, when you just ride around in a Jeep and look at animals, they have what they call a sundowner, and that was me practicing being a person that carries stuff on their head. And they just open up this full bar for you, and so you're in the middle of the savannah.
Really?
Well, you realize how small we are on this planet. I'm sitting there holding a beer, and all of a sudden I hear the guy go, oh, my. And I look, and literally from me to you was a hyena just kind of looking as I go, this is probably my last beer.
Because aren't they supposed to be, I don't know anything about savannah animals, and I should. Aren't hyenas supposed to be mean?
They're Satan's dog, is what it is.
Oh, wow.
And they make this horrible noise. The thing that was weirdest to me was like, because Gail put this whole trip together. And she goes, we're going to do 3 weeks in Africa. I'm like, okay. You know, there's a zoo
right there.
So we had to go get shots. Uh-huh. We had to get like 9 shots, but we got them at a grocery store.
Yeah.
Which is so weird to say, hey, we're here for the inoculation. Hey, Kevin, when you get done spritzing the radishes, we need some inoculations here. You know?
But it worked. You're fine.
And then, okay, people always say this, and I've heard this with other people. That is the bucket list trip of all
time. It is really worth doing. We did the funniest thing was when we were doing the gorillas. We literally hiked like for 2 hours up a mountain like this. And my friend had said, get a porter. And I said, what's the point? He said, it's a guy that helps you. I go, well, I'll get one for Gail. She had already booked 2 of them. Thank God she booked.
She thought ahead.
20 minutes into this hike, I'm like a 4-year going, Daddy, pull me up the hill.
Oh, my God. Does he literally lug you up the hill?
Literally pulls you up because it had rained. And so we get there, and this guy comes out of the jungle with a gun, which I'm like, what's up with that? And he whispers something to the guide, she says, the gorillas are just around the corner, she said. So I need everybody to kind of hunch over and start going, And I said, now I'm looking for cameras.
Right.
Yeah. You know, this is stupid.
Yeah, right.
I said, why are we doing, And she goes, well, that just tells the gorillas everything's cool. And I'm like, you don't speak gorilla.
Right.
What if it means like, hey, I'm kind of in the mood and here comes this big
show. Yeah.
Yeah,
was there ever a moment, Bill, where you thought, uh-oh, this could be it?
Yes, there was. There was a picture where there was what they call a teenager gorilla. And even a teenager gorilla easily could snap your head off.
Yeah.
So I'm like literally from me to you and I'm filming this and I go, this gorilla's like 3 feet away from me. And I swear he just went like this. He went and like slapped at me. And the lady goes, okay, I need you to get up very slowly and back away going, ugh. And I'm like, what's with the ugh? And literally the mother looked at me and like, okay, they just lay around and eat. It was,
wow.
But I'm gonna tell you something, when you look in their eyes, you know where we came from.
Wow.
There was like a 3-day-old baby that the mother was breastfeeding, you know, no blanket, no nothing, just, you know, there. And it was an amazing trip. But I did discover this, that if you ever are going to die on the savannah, I can tell you that it's not going to be quick and it's not going to be pretty.
Hmm. Okay.
We literally pulled up on a wild dog that had pulled down this impala and was literally eating it while it's still alive.
Oh,
and of course, the Impala's looking at us like, hey, you got a gun, take him out, please.
Help me.
You know, but it was amazing. But the kids were just, I just fell in love with those. I wanted to bring every one of them home. Oh. I mean, it was like, because your first thought is, oh my God, they're so poor, but they don't know.
Yeah.
So to them, they enjoy life, and right. It was a great, great trip, and it is something you should do at least once in your life, because it's going to go. It's going to go away.
We're going to take a break. Bill was here to talk about this movie called Monster Party, which I understand is fantastic. It's available on iTunes. But now we're all going to travel to
Africa
with Bill. Good to see you this morning.
Buddy, thanks.
Thank you, Bill.